What's up? Welcome back to the Sugatan YouTube channel. It's been a while since we've had a chat. I've been off camera. I've been doing the things behind the scenes, but I'm back today. Jan is away on holiday. I hope you're having fun, Jana, being away for 3 weeks while we stay in work. I really hope you're having fun. So in the marketing team, we decided let's bring Callum back for an ad reaction. For the last few days, I have been saving some organic TikTok ads that I've seen, some from like well-known influencers and some from just random people. And we're gonna go through them and break them down. Okay, so this is the first ad.
Good, I'm so hungry.
Yeah.
Are you okay? Where'd you go?
Up here, my love. Is that the McDonald's crispy chicken sandwich?
Yeah, I was just gonna... Wait, where'd it go?
The flavors are melting on my tongue! Toodles!
Wait, that's my sit. Wait.
Did you really think I would eat your sandwich? Ooh, silly, silly little girl. Here, take it. You deserve it.
Aww! April Fools!
I think I'm in love!
With me?
The sandwich! Ew!
This looks so good. I'm so hungry.
Okay, wow. There's a lot to unpack here. So, you know what? I think an ad, making an ad for something like McDonald's is super difficult because it's not like they can, you can't make a traditional ad and be like, yo, buy this burger because it's super good for you. These are the health benefits, because there are none. It's not a healthy sandwich. Like literally the only benefit fast food has is like, yo, this tastes nice. Like this is good. So they have to be creative, and my word, they have been creative. This ad is literally the definition of like, never let them know your next move, because you can't predict anything that happens at all. I have to watch it again. I just like.
Are you okay? Wait, where'd you go?
Up here, my love. Is that the McDonald's crispy chicken sandwich?
Yeah, I was just gonna. Wait, where'd it go?
The flavors are melting on my tongue. Toodles.
Wait, that's my sit. Wait.
Did you really think I would eat your sandwich?
The accent change in the middle of he just swaps to like from like a weird like creature gremlin to a British roadman like midway through the video.
Ooh, silly, silly little girl. Here, take it. You deserve it.
Aww, April Fools!
This video wasn't even posted on the 1st of April. It was posted on the 8th of March. Like.
I'm in love
with me.
The sandwich.
Oh my
God. This looks.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what else there is to say. Like, you can't really make a traditional ad about a McDonald's sandwich. Under the circumstances, they've done a great job. Like, I don't know if it hasn't inspired me to go buy this. I don't want a crispy chicken sandwich after watching this, but it's maybe given me a bit of a craving for McDonald's. Like, that's probably the most it's done. Yeah. What else can I say? Next ad is for basically a Grammarly alternative. So. The benefits of an organic ad like this is that you can use really popular TikTok sounds. This is a viral sound at the moment. I've seen plenty of videos about it. So, you know, you don't have to worry about the music that you're using or copyright or anything like that. So that would be the benefit of organic ads. In terms of the ad itself, I read pretty quickly and this is too fast. I don't like the way the text and the background clash. So the first time I saw this, I had to pause it. afterwards to be able to read everything. So we don't talk about the level of embarrassment you go through asking a friend to reread your essay. It's the first slide. And we never will meet your new best friend, Quillbot. Like, that was fine. This part was just way too fast, and the text completely like clashes with the background. So the friend that will check your grammar, give you actually useful writing advice, and won't make you feel stupid. They didn't really demonstrate it, in my opinion. They didn't demonstrate what the product does like that well. I don't know whether it does it fix spelling mistakes, does it like check sentence structure, does it give alternative words, does it give alternative phrases, does it give you the feeling of your text. They haven't said any of that. And then in this part, the friend that will check your grammar, give you actually useful writing advice, and won't make you feel stupid. What is actually useful writing advice? Is that to like include more adjectives, or is that to read more books? Because that also improves your writing skills. You know, it hasn't really like told me what the product does. And then these few lines, the friend that will check your grammar, give you actually useful writing advice, and won't make you feel stupid. Like, I feel like the whole ad itself, even the opening sentence, is so unnecessarily upside down the way it's worded. It makes me feel like, bro, you need this app to make your ads. Like, you need to run your ads through Quillbot before you put them on TikTok. Because the English is just, it's not wrong, but it's just kind of like, it's weirdly written. So in terms of selling me on Quillbot, I will stick to Grammarly. Thank you. Aside from the fact that Sugatan pays for everyone for Grammarly, I'll stick to Grammarly anyway. This is the okay, this next ad, we obviously know who this is. This is Mr. Beast. So automatically there's a bonus to this ad. He didn't have to make an ad that would necessarily go viral. But taking away from the fact that it's Mr. Beast, if this was just some random person, that's
secret to get tens of millions of views. Step one. This is the
So, you know, he starts the video with, this is the secret to get tens of millions of views. So that's just like a straight up hook. Like, everyone wants to know how to go viral.
Secret to get tens and of then millions of views. Step one.
And then basically just transitions to this screen advertising a movie. It's really clickbaity seeming to me. That's like an ad starting with, this video will teach you how to become a billionaire, and then it just cuts to something completely random and unrelated. Even if you look at the comments, that's one way to really upset people. Me, hearts the video. The bad guy ad appears, me, unheart. Like, people were pretty annoyed about that. I think the movie is like about, it's like some animation about criminals or something. I've never seen it, but like just reading the comments, that's kind of what I picked up. So it does sort of make sense because they like stole his video. That was the vibe I think they were going for. But this is not the way to hook people into watching your ads, just blatantly talking about something completely different and then tricking people into watching an ad. Technically not wrong, but like, no, don't do that. And you can see that by the comments. People are quite mad. So now the next one is actually more of a profile. It's Ryanair. Ryanair is an airline in Europe, like a budget airline. And I would say out of every company on TikTok, they have the absolute best videos. Like, their videos are just incredible. They go viral all the time and they're really funny. And the coolest part about Ryanair, let's just watch a few of their ads that I've saved.
Ariana, what are you doing here?
I am Jose Mourinho.
Keep your eyes closed. I have a surprise.
Did you do the dishes?
I said surprise, not miracle.
Ryanair's got a bit of like a stigma in Europe for being like slightly dodgy. And they just like lean into that. They just make a joke about it. Like they're like, listen, you're saying Ryanair is dodgy, but you're still here. You're still flying Ryanair. And then all the other videos, they manage to perfectly jump on trends. Like I envy the person that comes up with these ideas. Like they perfectly jump on every single trend. They just get it right every single time, while at the same time going like, yo, just so you know, our flights are 10 euros. Like, you know, just putting it out there. They're not going, fly Ryanair, our flights are 10 euros. They're being funny and also getting the message across that their flights are like super cheap and you can go anywhere in Europe for 10 euros. So it's just a really clever way of marketing. And they're also super active in the comments as well, which is sick. Like people will leave a comment and the admin replies. They're just like really interactive with their audience, and that's super important as a brand, as a company. Like if I was in Europe, no matter how dodgy the Ryanair flight is, I would be kind of inclined to be like, you know what, it's 10 euros and they're a sick company, like they're a fun company, I'm gonna fly Ryanair. That's the kind of feeling that I get from these videos. And you know what? I'm a millennial / Gen Z. I would do it just for the memes. Like, just because they have a funny TikTok account.
Did you do the dishes?
I said surprise, not mirror.
Like this one. This is another, like, they lean into stuff that people generally make fun of them for. So they actually turn, like, things that people pick on them about, they turn it into an advantage. People would say you only fly to London Stansted instead of London Heathrow, but then they're like, yeah, but it's still 12 euros. They do that consistently on their socials. They flip something negative into something positive. And that is why I love Ryanair's TikTok accounts, because they're just themselves. They don't try hide anything. They don't try pull the wool over anyone's eyes. They're like, listen, if you want cheap flights, fly Ryanair. If you want to fly to London Heathrow, don't fly Ryanair. They're just like unapologetically themselves on social media, which is super cool. And that is it from my side, guys, looking at some organic TikTok ads. Just having a little bit of fun while Jana is away on holiday, having more fun than me. I'm totally not bitter about it at all. Thank you for watching the video. Please remember to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next week for some cool content from Chris and Marina and Matas over in Europe. Maybe they'll fly Ryanair. You never know.